Click the subscribe button and on notification bell icon to get all notifications of my channel. Hey, what's up you guys? This is Akilan from Akilan Tech, and today I'm going to tell you what is VGA camera and what is the difference between optical image stabilization and electronic image stabilization, and the difference between optical and digital zoom and the Oppo 10X optical zoom. So let's get started. First, we're gonna see what is VGA camera. VGA camera is nothing but, the VGA stands for Video Graphic Array. In this VGA camera, the resolution will be 640 into 480 pixels. And you can see this VGA camera in the older phones before 5 years or 6 years. And now in the feature phones also, you can see the VGA camera. Now we got the 2 megapixel, 5 megapixel, 8 megapixel, 10 megapixel. But in the olden days, there was not these many megapixels onto a camera. So they have kept this VGA camera. This VGA camera is only 0.3 megapixels. Actually, 1 megapixel is equal to 10 lakh pixels. And now we are using 10 megapixels also, means 1 crore pixels. But in the olden days, as there is only 0.3 megapixel camera, it is only 3 lakh pixels. And we can see this VGA camera in the feature phones like the Nokia Lumia phones and another etc. phones. And we can see in some phones like Coolpad, they are using this VGA camera as a secondary camera. As we can see in the dual camera setups in phones, the primary camera is 12 megapixel like that. But in the secondary camera, they are keeping VGA camera in some phones like Coolpad. This is about VGA camera. And next we're gonna see the digital zoom versus optical zoom. First we're gonna see the optical zoom. Optical zoom is nothing but this optical zoom. There will be an extra camera. Like as I told you, we're having the dual camera, triple camera, quad camera setups. And now the recently Nokia has launched the Penta camera. Why these many cameras are needed in a phone? Means in this camera setup, the main camera will be the primary camera, and the other cameras are like for depth sensor and wide angle lens and for etc. In this we can see the telephoto lens. This telephoto lens is used for optical zoom. Means in this optical zoom, actually what will happen in this optical zoom is, along with the primary camera, one more camera will be added in the phone. This optical camera, when we zoom, we're gonna see the details very clearly. Means this optical zoom is also called as lossless zoom. But when we see the digital zoom, this digital zoom is not related to any hardware, it is related to software. We will have only one camera in our phone. This digital zoom, now we can see in every phone like in Redmi Note 4 or Redmi Note 3, in the phones where we have only single camera, there we can see when we open the camera, we can zoom in. That zoom is known as a digital zoom. In this digital zoom, there is no any hardware part. It is only related to the software. In this digital zoom, there is no any separate camera. Only with the primary camera and with the software, they're gonna zoom it very clearly. But in this digital zoom, the clarity is gonna miss. If we compare the optical zoom and the digital zoom, the optical zoom, when we zoom it, in the mobile phone, we're gonna see the details very clearly. But whereas in the digital zoom, when we zoom, the clarity gonna miss and the details gonna miss when we compare to the optical zoom. And this optical zoom is found in higher-end mobiles like the iPhone, Samsung, and OnePlus. It means as we are keeping another camera, the optical zoom gonna cost a very high price. That's why we're gonna not see this optical zoom in the budget category like 10,000 or 20,000 budget category. And next we're gonna see the image stabilization. Now we have two types of image stabilizations, like optical image stabilization and the electronic image stabilization. I think you have heard these words like OIS and the EIS. First we're gonna see the OIS, that is the optical image stabilization. In this optical image stabilization, the optical lenses are added. For example, in the daytime, when you go out and take pictures in your phone, when you take pictures, or not only pictures, if we see the video also, this optical image stabilization does this. Actually, when we take the photo, what will happen means the shutter opens and the light comes inside and touches the sensor, and after the light touches the sensor, the shutter closes. When the light touches the sensor, when you take the photo appears and we can see the photo. But this is okay for the morning time. But with the same phone, if you take the photos in the night time, that is in the low light conditions, when the shutter opens for a long time, because as the light to come in, the shutter opens for a long time. But till that time, if the shutter is open, and at any moment our hands will shake, as you know, It is a truth that when we catch anything, the hands will shake a little moment. So when the shutter is open and when the hands are shaken, the image quality will be reduced because the image will also come in a blur way. So to overcome this problem, the optical image stabilization has been implemented. Actually, what happens when the optical image stabilization is implemented means, for example, you are taking a video like this, and when you move the phone this side, the optical image stabilization sensor gonna react to the opposite side. Means the sensor gonna move this side, so the image will be stabilized. If you move not only that side, if you move upside, the sensor will move downside. If you move the downside, the sensor will move upside. If you move the right side, the sensor will move to the left side. With this, the image will not be shaken and the image will come in a very good way. This is the use of the optical image stabilization. You can see this optical image stabilization in the higher-end mobiles like iPhone, Samsung, OnePlus and Huawei and etc. phone. And if you come to the low budget category like the 10,000 or 20,000 budget, they're gonna use the electronic image stabilization. So this electronic image stabilization gonna crop the video. When you're taking a video, when you shake the video, after the video is processed, you can see as when the electronic image stabilization is there, you can see that you are zooming in. Means you can see that you are cropping in. This happens in the electronic image stabilization because the electronic image stabilization crops the video in. And this is about the electronic image stabilization. And the first phone to implement optical image stabilization was Nokia Lumia 920. In this phone, the first optical image stabilization was implemented. And this is about the stabilization. And next, you can see the Oppo 10X Zoom. Recently in the February month, we have seen the MWC event. In this MWC event, the Oppo has launched their Oppo 10X Zoom. And they have confirmed that in the 2019 quarter 2, a proper phone implemented with Oppo 10X optical zoom gonna come to the market. This 10X optical zoom gonna work with the mirror mechanism. Actually, a periscope lens has been implemented in the middle of the sensor. Actually, Oppo has brought a phone to the demo in the MWC event. In this phone, there is a main camera 48 megapixel and the secondary camera is the ultra wide angle lens at the 16 mm wide focal length. And the third camera is the 10X optical zoom sensor with the 160 mm focal length. In this 10X optical zoom, the Oppo has kept periscope lens between the sensor. Actually, what happens is when the light comes inside and touches the mirror, the sensor, the image sensor is placed at an angle, and when the light comes and touches the sensor, you're gonna see the 10X optical zoom. In this Oppo, when they have shown the photos with captured with the 10X optical zoom, now on the screen you can see the photos of the 10X optical zoom. If you see that, we're gonna see that there is no loss in the zoom. It's a lossless zoom. But we're gonna see practically how this is gonna work, because if you see in the DSLR, there is a space between the lens and the camera. So when we zoom it, we can zoom it to 10X and more than 10X, because there is a gap. But in the camera, there is no space between the camera sensor and the phone. So we're gonna see how this practically gonna work. And I think with this video, you got an idea about what is VGA camera and the difference between optical image stabilization and the electronic image stabilization, and the difference between optical zoom and the digital zoom and Oppo's 10X zoom. If you find this video informative, hit that like button and share it to your friends as much as possible. If you have any doubts, comment in the comment box below. I'll definitely answer your question. Do subscribe my channel by clicking the Akilan Tech logo and clicking subscribe button. This is Akilan signing off. I'll see you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Peace.